you know, as a caver, you always dream about finding, you know, the next big cave and being the one to find the next discovery. It was really the true last frontier on, you know, in the earth that we don't know. You know, right here in your backyard in South Dakota, it's very exciting, and I think it's a neat thing to have right here.
What it is for the park is a natural museum. So it's incredibly important because we don't have this sort of thing elsewhere in the Black Hills, really.
I was out in this area looking for caves. It seemed like a logical place for the cave to be, the right limestone, and it had some airflow coming out of it. And from experience, I know that air comes from a void. It doesn't come from a solid, you know, solid ground. It has to come out of a hole. So I knew that that was a good indication that there was a, you know, bigger cave here.
Persistence cave.
We have a Thompson speaker bat. This is the skull room.
It is a small, cramped environment. You know, when say you were digging, it's not like you're standing there with a shovel and like you are in your garden. You know, you're on your belly, you know, with generally like a garden hand trowel or a little garden hoe or a little shovel and scooping it into, we use a old turkey roaster pan and scoop it into that, and somebody pulls it out behind you. And so it's a pretty slow process. So if we get, you know, 10, 15 feet in a day, we're pretty happy. And then you just dig to a size that you think you can fit through, you know. So most of us, that's probably, you know, at least 8 inches high we like to go. Then we like to go a little bit deeper. You know, we're trying to make it at least a foot, if not a foot and a half high, just to make it comfortable. So we figure if we're going to be going in and exploring this cave for years to come, we might as well make it at least somewhat comfortable now. Because once we're exploring big cave, we're not going to want to back up and do more work on it. Started digging and we started finding some bones in the dirt. So then we said, oh, we better stop here for, you know, a bit and have somebody, you know, start looking at these bones.
And I took a look, and within the first, I don't know, cup of sediment, we were finding bones. Within the first couple bags, it was thousands of bones. And one of the first bones to come out is what they call a pika, and it's a relative of the rabbit. And they're not in the mountains today. They're found, the closest would be the Bighorn Mountain, so let's say 150, 200 miles away. What is that doing here? So immediately it says climate change, interesting things. So we're getting, oh, I'd say by now we probably have at least 50 different types of animals. Frogs and salamanders.
This is a camel toe bone. So it would be essentially this one right here.
I don't know what brought the camel in. That would be interesting. And the bone is just, I mean, from across the room you can say, oh yeah, that's camel. So there's no problem identifying that. Now the bison presents an interesting scenario because the bison we're getting out of this cave is larger than today's bison that occur just down the hill from us here. Why is that? Well, we're finding that all over the place. And we're finding that as climate changed starting about 18,000 years ago, the bison started to get smaller. And about 9,000-10,000 years ago, it really became smaller. Smaller in the sense of it's getting close to the size we see today in the park. You never know what you're gonna find, so it's kind of fun to peer through it, but realize we're going through tens of thousands of bones, and we have one person sorting all that bone. One bag that is down to about this size of sediment will take about 40 hours to sort the bone from.
You walk around here on the surface, you don't know you're walking, you know, what's underground, you know, so you have to go underground and get into that cave to see what kind of resources are you finding in the cave. And, you know, and so far in Wind Cave, the things we've, you know, discovered, you know, underground lakes in the cave, new formations and minerals that haven't been seen anywhere else in the world.
Elsewhere in the park, we have evidence of cave formations and fossils going back 250,000. Could they find that here? That would be incredibly interesting. There's lots of questions, and we barely opened the door. It's all very exciting because, well, it's just like Mark and Blaze going into the cave and finding something, a new passage. We're finding new species that are not known from here.
Entrance?
It's significant because we're finding past history, natural history of the Black Hills that we don't know. It's significant to find out what's happening with these caves so that the National Park has an idea of what's happening with their caves and where are they. It's significant because of the potential of climate change.